So, in what you have on the table, to me, you have a 30 kilowatt system. Maybe 50 kilowatt system. You understand?
Yeah, that's what I'm shooting for, basically, yeah.
Book number two was The Structure of the Life. It wasn't to talk about the life. It's to carry the information how matters move in the universe. Book number two was The Structure of the Life. It wasn't to talk about the life. It's to carry the information how matters move in the universe. If you are a ball and you want to go in to fly in the environment, you have a big resistance. You have a bigger surface ahead of you. So when you narrow yourself, you become a ray, what we call a light. It's easier to go faster. So book number one was about the structure, understanding correctly. Book number two was about the movement of this thing. Book number three was the collection of these things how behave. Book number four shows conversion of these things into matter, what we call a solar system. Solar systems are matter conversion systems. Solar systems behave like a blood vessel, convert energy into matter. You understand? So go into understanding the structure of the plasma, not matter. Then you understand you want different layers of, let's say, centralization through radiation. You can get centralization with argon, you can get it with helium, you can get it with nitrogen. In the body of man, centralization is done by nitrogen, not by anything else. You don't have argon in your blood. Yeah? In the upper atmosphere on Earth, the centralization conversion is done by nitrogen. In different parts of the universe, it's done by argon and heavier because of the condition in the environment where they are. The closer you get to the center point, so to what we call a black hole, what we call a principal matter, the stronger knife you need to cut. So, in your little tube in the back, you can produce as much energy as you like. You want to be warmer, you move closer to the sun. You want to be cooler, you move to the Saturn. You understand? So you have to find a position in respect to your center. With putting that ball in the middle, you dictate the center. You dictate the position of the center. When you have that core in the middle, and then you create a vacuum outside it, you have already fixed the position of the center. Now move in your outer chamber where you want to be. You understand?
Dr. Keshe, can I put my nose in for a minute?
Yes.
If we apply a magnetic field inside the tube, inside the plasma, would it affect it in a positive way? Or
depends what you put in there, how you create it. You want to add to it or you want to withdraw from it? You understand? It depends what you want to do. The way you've done your structure is fantastic. It's beautiful what you've done. The way you show it with the outer chamber you built, with putting that plasma in the middle, you already have dictated the sun.
Right.
You have the position of the sun. Yeah?
Exactly.
With your second chamber, you decide you want to be on the Earth position or you want to be on the Saturn. You want to be warmer, you come to the Earth. You want to take more energy out, you come to the Earth position. You want to take less energy out, you want 100 kilowatts, you come to the Earth position. You go near your plasma. The 10 watts, you go to Saturn position. You want a few microns, you go further out than in Pluto sector. This is the easiest way to convert it. The closer you come to this point, with putting that core in the middle, you have already fixed the position of the plasma. All the plasmas respond to that position, unless they are stronger, which then that plasma responds to them. You can make a stronger plasma outside, but you have to reposition it. This is what we call 360 rotation speed. We, in the space industry, in a spaceship program, what we call, it's in my papers, on the net, you use 120 degree separation reactors. So you want to increase the direction of motion, you don't have a jet propulsion to go in that direction. In a space technology, when you want to move like the Iranian spaceship program, you see them flying with a high speed, they use a specific combination of reactors. You want to create energy from certain point, you bring the magnetic field in that position. You understand? So you do the same thing in your reactor. It's one concept, it's one principle, it's the application which changes it. You understand?
Yes, thank you, yes.
Okay, so
you have, sorry about that. So in what you have on the table, to me, you have a 30 kilowatt system, maybe 50 kilowatt system. You understand?
Yeah, that's what I'm shooting for, basically, yeah.
So it depends how close you want to be. When we get close to the sun, we burn. Why? Because there is a stronger magnetic gravitational field, which our body gets dissolved into it. Huh? When you go further out, it's cooler because the fields have already lost some of their strength to the other fields in the area. Yeah? And then you have to understand the position of the gravity you create in your center core. Gravitational magnetic field in the center core decides where the matter happens. If the sun had a stronger gravitational magnetic field, the matter of Earth most probably would have been in Jupiter level or Saturn. Yeah? But because it has such a gravitational magnetic, the Earth matter conversion is at the position where it is now. You have the same thing in there. That's what I say, a farmer, a man in a village in Africa should be able to produce food energy from a simple system. If he goes in a car graveyard, everything which to produce energy is in a car graveyard. And the cars are everywhere. If you have a mobile phone, use the component of the mobile phone, you can create as much energy as you like. Understand the structure. And then the application is the same.
We did have an idea to take with a plasma ball, put a cell phone, tape it onto each side and see what happened there, because you did mention something about cell phones and...
But the minute you touch it, you create transfer of matter energy. You have to keep it away. We did a test. I had a knock on the door. They said, excuse me, do you mind shutting your system? The whole building has run out of, nobody can get through the communication line. No, but I'm talking a building, 5-story high, 6-story high, all concrete, about 100 meter circumference, easy, maybe more. With running a system of less than 10 centimeters, we could block the whole communication line. This is how I wrote in there that, you know, the people came to knock on the door, says, can you close the thing down in your lab because nobody can talk in the building anymore. We realized the strength of it.
Yes, right.
All you do, you create a dynamic field which everything gets stays inside. Fields don't gravitate out, they cannot move out, and whatever comes out from outside. This is how the satellite was captured, how the American plane was captured. You literally, the system is the size of a smaller than a ping pong ball you can make it. Yeah? But it creates such a dynamism that it doesn't block communication. It centralizes, like a centrifuge, holds all the fields internally, so nothing can go because it's stronger. You do the same thing with your system. It's not a jamming system, but you need this in deep space for specific uses, where you want to absorb energy. When you run out of food, you want to absorb energy. You can't wait until you are near the sun. You create in your reactor condition that all the smallest fields gets absorbed and it gets attracted and you produce what you like from it. It's a process of understanding. in the system you have there, you can produce as much energy for the rest of your life if you know how to tap into it. You have a power generator on the table.
Right. Well, that's our work, is to unlock those secrets, and
secret.
Appreciate your input on that.
No, it's no secret. Look at the structure of the universe. Yeah? We know it all. We deny the knowledge to ourselves. We have it all within us. It's just, that's what I said, peer reviewing. These people who peer review for their own pocket put that mindset on us.
Yes, right. Yeah? I know it's, for me, it was a major revelation to run into your writings and teachings, because it resonated so well to what I knew was true and that I wasn't getting from the ordinary sources.
You see, the understanding comes in the stages. You can't understand everything altogether. Desiree was with me on Monday in the office. We had a girl who flew in from Norway. Yeah, she has an MS, very young, in her early 30s. And we've been building MS system for people to reverse, to trying to find a solution for MS. 6-7 years ago, I was very happy if I could get people with MS moving their legs or their feet and whatever, because I looked for physicality. And it's taken me 10 years, more or less, in research in MS and that kind of thing. While I was putting the system on for her, I realized how far away from reality I have worked, even with my research, because I ignored one of the most principal things which leads to production of MS. You understand? Leads to causing MS. Now, I built a system for her which is totally different than before, but still it's a halfway house, because while I was putting, I learned more, exactly what to look for, I hope, a step further, but I don't have that much knowledge to make the system. But I know what system I have to make, that in reality it should be the size of a cup to sort the MS out. Not these shoes and helmets and the things which we reverse. Because I did what you did, I went for physicality. But in the process of learning, now I know where the gap in my knowledge has been, or I looked in the wrong direction, or I didn't have enough knowledge to see the next step. But is this a step, the final step? I don't think so. Because now, from what I understand, with the structure of the human body, exactly how you're learning from YouTube, is even you can give me MS without me knowing. I don't need my own body to create a disease. Other people can give you a disease without them knowing. You understand? It's a condition of environment. You understand? So you have the condition of environment in that reactor. You have to be very careful. I work with these things. Don't ever stay near to them. Stay always. Whenever you run your reactor, just because you don't see things doesn't mean things don't happen. This is how I got the cancer of pancreas and liver. Yeah? I work too close. So just because you don't see anything, these things release different wavelengths. For you to see that light which is in there, it means the light has to emit to get to you. So it goes in different levels of energy. Yeah? It's better to see further than the closer.
Right. Well, we do have a remote control for the for our magnetic drive motor here, and we're able to stand back for that kind of thing. And
you see, that pipe you have from your reactor to your pump is too short. It's too short.
Okay.
You're close to it. You try to use, if you have a space, try to get rid of everything on a table and leave your reactor on its own on a separate table, so it forces you to keep a certain distance.
Right.
You understand?
Good point.
This is the way you have to work to safeguard yourself.